Sexy people of the interwebs. Oh, how y'all doing? Why y'all all sideways and everything? Here comes the squeaky squeak. Okay, let's get this party started, because yesterday's video sucked ass. So let's get y'all updated and motivated and shit like that. Bye. Okay, I'm leaking here. It's refill time, so we'll refill while we're catching up. Yesterday, I was live from Monticello, Arkansas, which apparently has the worst interwebs for phones in the universe. It was bad enough going in. I lost phone. I was on phone with Ryan and dropped that phone call and didn't have anything for a while. And then my, there's Ryan. Speak of Ryan, speak of the devil. Lost the call with Ryan, like I said. All that business. It was horrible. And then I tried to go live. It said I had 4G. It said I had a couple of bars. But the pixelated shit that I saw, was horrible. I didn't even watch the video. You know, I was just, you know, eyeballing it to see if it was as bad as I thought. And it was worse. So I was like, well, fuck. But I'm going to leave it up there. Fuck it. You know, because some people like shit like that. Some people like chaos in their life. I do not. I'm not that guy. But, you know, I got to cater to an audience here, man. I got an audience that I have to cater to. I have to, you know, put it all out there. So, I got loaded with, I don't know how much foam. I know the quantity. I know the board feet is over 35,000 board feet. Loaded front to the back, side to side, top to bottom. Lots and lots of styrofoam. Feel like y'all are in the wrong spot. So, yeah, I'm refilling my juice. Gotta get some more juice when I get back to town. Gotta head back to town now. So I got the prescription notifications that they've been filled, and right about that time is the time I need to start heading home and get my prescriptions, because I'm gonna run out, and nobody wants that. Trust me. Nobody wants that. Whole fucking family, man. They always ask me, did you take your medicine? Did you take your medicine? Why do you ask? Apparently, I am an extreme asshole or something, I guess. I don't know. There's that. So, I gotta go home. So, that's what I'll be looking for on the load board with the quickness. Something that'll head towards the casa. But anyway, I didn't get loaded till after midnight. I got there sometime around 4 yesterday at Joe Nathan. Sometime around 4 yesterday afternoon, I rolled up to get loaded, and it was after midnight when I got out of there. And got about 13 seconds of sleep before he woke me up, said they were done, had me sign the paperwork. I tried to get out of Arkansas. I was trying to make it. Hey, Smooth, how you doing? Trying to make it to at least Missouri. I did not make that. Got into the mountains, into the Ozarks of, I'm changing batteries. That's what we're doing right now. Currently, we're changing batteries. Just to make sure we got a full battery. See? Take that battery out. Bada bing, bada boom. Put the replacement battery in. Golden, roll that little thingy in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're on like Donkey Kong. We're fresh. I did not do that today. Now we got to put that dude in there to be chargy. And in case you were wondering, which you're not, but I'm gonna show you anyway. Well, no, I changed my mind. I'm not going to show you. I got another one of these up there somewhere floating around. Backup, little backup battery. Okay. Put that up there. Man, there's so much. I can hear everything that's going on over here, but they're way the fuck over there. There's a door way over there somewhere, but I can hear them like they're right here at the back of the truck. Hell, y'all can probably hear them. That sounded awesome. All right, so got loaded after midnight, hauled ass. I had to shut it down. I got me a shower at the Pilot on the way. Are you bringing me my paperwork? Drive all the way over here to bring me the paperwork? Hey Dave, hey Darren. Got a visitor. With no reason for this. I really don't want to listen to that boom boom music. Thank you. Ugh. Was I? Let me check this. I gotta make sure this is working here. Anyway, they're unloading right now. I'm at the Consignee. We got to the shower part. I was gonna tell y'all something about that. I did something god awful. Of course, there was nowhere to park in the middle of the night last night to get that shower. So there was only one other truck on this massive fuel island. So I pulled up to the fuel island. I dumped all my trash, and I put the trash can behind my truck. I just pulled up to the yellow line and put the trash can right behind the truck, so nobody would pull up to that one. I went inside, took a shower. I was there an hour. That wasn't a dirty 30, man. That was a double dirty 30. Double dirty 30. But I got something new, and I got two of them, and I like the first one. They put chicken. I don't know, Joe Nathan. I have no idea. I don't know how many hours I got. Probably very few. Even if I got creative, I'm not sure I'd have a lot of hours to do anything other than maybe get picked up some fucking where. I might, whenever I get through, I might get on here and look at loads, see if there's something, you know, going out late that might pick up. But most likely, I'm going to go over here to the corner and in a little mooch dock spot and hibernate for the rest of the night. I don't know. We'll see. Got my shower. I didn't move that fucking trash can. That's why I'm confessing, man. I'm confessing. Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. It has been a few hours since I sinned last and confessed last, or whatever you do. I left that fucking trash can. I just drove off. I left that fucking trash can. I just remembered it, man. I had to confess it, man. Anyway, so I did my double dirty 30. And got the fuck out of there, and then I hit the brick wall and I couldn't go anymore. I had to shut down. So I shut down and I went to sleep for about 4 or 5 hours till the phone started ringing and woke me up. That does not mean the phone didn't ring. The phone rang. I missed calls. I have no idea how many calls I missed. I'm not even paying attention. I only know that I missed a call from the broker. I called the broker back and real nice lady, Teresa there, called me, and I gave her the update on stuff, and she said they can get me, I thought I had to be here by 3, she said they can get me unloaded up to 5, I'm like, well, give them a little buzz and let them know I'll be there around 4, so they don't have to stay late, and I got here right before 4, it's like, it was 3:56 or some shit, 3:58, yeah. time to fucking bomb, dude. And there was, it was pouring down rain coming over here, pouring down. Wrecks everywhere. All the way, all over the fucking highway. Both sides, fucking lights and, oh man, fucking road just shut down at times. We're just creeping along and shit. I still got here early. Cause I know this place pretty well. Not, I haven't mastered it, but I know it pretty well. I know how to get around. And I really, really like this place. I would consider moving to Kansas City. If I were going to relocate, I would, for business reasons, I would consider moving to business up here. Probably not my physical body and all my shit, but I might find a little spot that'll fit a truck and a trailer or two and create a little terminal up here, but I would never be there. Very seldom. I don't know. Try to get that Kansas City loop thing going on again. Also, I'm trying to get the a little loop, a Dallas to Houston loop going. I bid on a contract for that. I talked to the guy yesterday. I think I was talking to y'all about that on the last video, but I don't know if y'all got that. I don't know. I don't remember if I shared that with you. Well, I got that going on. I'm working that. I'm working that angle right now. Trying to lessen the miles, increase the revenue, blah, 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 blah. Getting a shorter lane, mastering a lane. Creating a situation where it's such a short, you know, the freight doesn't have to go that far, that if I put a terminal, Georgia to Louisiana. Yeah, somebody asked me about that recently. That was a couple videos ago. Yeah, they called me about that. I don't want that. I don't want that. That's all fucking beer. It's heavy as fuck. And it's not a loop, really. It's one way. They're starting their contract. Now, this is cotton. It's still heavy. It's cotton. Dallas down to Baytown by Houston. And I bid it high, and the dude didn't even blink. I wanted to make it where even if you took the shit down and turned around and deadheaded back to get another one, you're not gonna make a whole lot of money doing that. Don't get me wrong, but you're gonna make a minimum per day. The round trip is it's you know like 250, 260 down and then back. And if you get a load going back, you know that's gravy on the biscuit. I mean, theoretically working 7 days a week, if you were to grab a constant load going back, a consistent load going back, which you work on the contract side on that one too, after you get the first one going down. But you could easily gross 12,000 a week, working 7 days a week, go down, drop, and get 10 hours off every day. For those who are in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, you'd be home every night. Yeah. Hey, Big Red, how you doing? So I'm working on that contract right now, and I'm gonna go ahead and bid on some others while I'm at it. Those projects, you know, they'll go 20, 30, 50 weeks or something like that, and I wasn't even paying that much attention, I guess, because my bid isn't on the board anymore. I can't go back and look at it like I was looking at it before. So I don't remember how long this project lasts. I think it was 50 weeks. Even if it was 30 weeks, that's still fine. There's 52 weeks in a year. So if it's 30, that's 6 months. 6 months to get through what we're going through right now with the spot market rates going down and all the bullshit. I think we're done. I think they just finished. Anyway, so I'm working on contracts and stuff like that. We will see, man. We will see. Get a contract like that, you know. Yeah, she's, I think we're over, I know we're over 30 grand, grossed so far. Hey, Dan, how you doing? I gotta go back and look, cause things changed on my little dashboard with the, with the factoring company, so I can't just pull it up. I think I was operating on misinformation also, because I was showing y'all a number that I thought was the year-to-date total, but it's not. It's how much they currently have outstanding. The one below it is month-to-date. Now that's month-to-date, but the one above it wasn't. So as soon as the broker started paying their fucking bills, that number went down. I showed y'all like 27,000, but in reality, that thing the next day dropped to like 20. I'm like, I know I grossed over 20. I know that for a fact. So now I got to go in. I got to add them up one by one by one. Man. Anyway, looks like everybody's coming to work. Parking in the no parking zones and everything. Maybe they're picking up their people over here or something. Maybe that's why they're parking all crazy and whatnot. Got a lot of people parked a lot of different ways. 19 minutes. Everybody gets off work, I guess. It's already raining. It's raining on my fucking arm right now. To answer the question about Black Betty and all that, of course, you know, I got the oil leaks. That's just the way that it is. Hadn't decreased that much unless I put Lucas in, and then it slows down a little bit. Raining upper. I don't know what that means. But now I've got a new problem. I've got a new issue. Narrowed it down. Between 18 and 22 miles per hour, I get this wicked fucking like I'm driving over a really rough road or something. And it's consistent. I slow down to a certain speed, you know, get down in that speed range.
All right, so you're done.
Thank you, my friend. Gracias. Mr. Hernandez signed it for me. That was horrible. I don't need that. Big old fan on right there. You hear that? It's got that problem too. That is not the alternator, by the way. That is not the alternator. Uh-uh. I think it's the engine fan. I think there's something wrong with the clutch on the engine fan. I think there might be an air leak there too. But that 20 mile an hour thing, it bothered me last night really bad. I thought it was in the transmission. I thought it was in between fifth and sixth gear. I'd get into fifth gear, 20 mile. I'm like, God damn, now I'm losing the transmission. I'm like, there's no way, you know. There's no way. It can't be the transmission. So I took it, put it in neutral, and slowed down. And as I slowed down, when I got below 22, I think it's that tire. The most expensive tire on this truck, the $1,200 fucking Michelin over there, I think there's something wrong with it. But I can't see anything. I looked all the way around it. I don't know. Hey, what's up? Fan clutch. Yeah. Yeah, I think that's what that is. I gotta close my back doors and slide my tendon in them. Oh, there's people coming to work. They just don't have enough places for people to park, I guess. This fucking parking lot is headed down into the drink over there, man. Be right back. I'm gonna take a second. Walking around, walking around. Oh, they're parking over there. That's what they're doing over there. Six people. There once was a boat that put to sea. The name of it was a Billy Hoochie. I got to move. Get the fuck out of here. Before I get all... I guess the second shift is coming on or something. I didn't know they had more than a first shift here. They do things here. They do a lot of things here. We're just moving to the other side, you know. There's a spot where I can back in. Anytime. Ooh. parking any time, any damn time. There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Billy O.T. Tell y'all, man, there is a mountain, an absolute mountain of styrofoam in that trailer, and I ain't taking it with me. Stinks too, man. Fucking trailers. Ow. What'd y'all say? What'd you say? Like, oh, gotta go to work. Okay, Jonathan. We'll see you later, man. Gold nugget for the day. Make sure you got two batteries for your blower if you carry styrofoam. Because I might have to carry an extra battery in there. I know I ain't getting all that shit out. No. Fucking engine blows oil all over the fucking place and gives me hell. Just little bitty things. Power steering fluid leak. I have to add power steering fluid, occasionally have to add a little coolant, definitely have to add oil, but it gets you from point A to point B, no problem, no problems, no worries, mate. Woo! It's horrible here, man. It's a horrible day. I don't think I'm gonna be looking for a load. I don't think I want a load right now. I don't know. I gotta go blow that shit out first. Give you a tour, Black Bay. What do you want to see? Like, for instance. You mean the inside or the outside? I'm gonna count on my fingers to figure out something here. Oh, outside? Okay. It's funky as fuck right now. I'll take you out there. Let's go for a... Let's go for a little... field trip. You hear that? 3 points of contact entering, exiting the vehicle. Goal in water. All right. I guess we'll go back here on and start back here with things that bother me. All right. Hey, Sydney. All right. I got to replace this one. I already replaced the one over there, but getting these rusty-ass motherfuckers off right there is kind of a thing. But I got the brand new one in the box I'm about to show you. I don't like the super singles, obviously, but those are really, really fucking shiny. And this was $1,000 tire. It's brand spanking new, you can see. I got nothing but tread. And the ones that came with it, lots of tread. Yeah. They're good tires. Good tires. She stops on a dime. Alright. You got the rusty parts of the frame that gotta be touched up along with my additive right there. There's the box that I added. Block three times, one in the middle and one on either side right there. I got the pogo stick in there with the things that hooky up right there. And she goes up, gotta put me a satellite up there, because why not, you know? I got a light right there that I don't know how to cut on. I have yet to figure out how to get the working light cut on, but I'm gonna put some lights up there on both sides, inside and out. So I'll have work lights down and back and shit like that. I don't have I don't have any luck whatsoever, good or bad, with the Super Singles. Well, this one, the reason it's new is it came from that family. It developed a blister on the side, a big old bubble, when I was in the oil field the first time last year. And I had to get that $1,000 fucking tire right there. It's $1,000+ installation. $1,000 for the tire. All right. Black Betty has 140-gallon saddle tanks each side, 280-gallon capacity. Of course, she looks like a stallion. Ain't nothing here. But soon, we'll have some boxes here, and we'll have a APU on the other side. We're going to go ahead and go with the APU. Yep, that's me right there. There is no fire extinguisher in there. Ooh, there I am in the reflection. There is no fire extinguisher in there. There are two fire extinguishers in here. So we put the bigger sign right there. Of course, that's the van. There's the truck number. And there's the fucking stacks. They painted them black. Yeah, she's a fucking paint job in the worst way. Now, another thing that bothers me. Yes, these are aluminum alloy. I got the replacement players at the house. Those are 24/5s. Those are 22/5s. 24/5, 22/5. Me no likey. So I've got one brand new tire and two rims. I just got to get another tire, and then we're going to replace these, and we're going to sell those off or some shit. And of course, she's got her blinky blinky lights. You've seen them before. She's got a little spot up there. Needs to be touched up. I'm actually gonna get up there and paint this silver. The top part of the truck and part of the sides will be silver. She'll be two-tone person. All right. The other side, basically the same, 24/5. And it's a different wheel too. See, the pattern on the other side are round. Those are oblong with a little thing on. I don't know where the fuck they got these from. Everything's same over here. Blah 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 blah. Battery box with my super duper job of, you know, connected to the batteries and putting the, what you call it in here, the you call it the damn inverter. Yes. Now, first thing I did when I got this truck is I took this little son of a bitch off, this bracket. It's a bracket just like that one. It's inside the truck right now because it had come loose from these little holes. And that's all aluminum. So I've got a, and I can't access this area from the inside. I just can't do it. So anyway, I got to put a plate on there and zap that bracket to it and then put that back on there. But it didn't go anywhere, so it's all right. Y'all know the box, the famous box. It's got so much shit in there, you wouldn't believe it. The area here, this, I don't know what was on this truck. This truck had one hell of a life before I got it. I know that it had a headache rack at one time, and I might end up going putting a headache rack on there just for extra storage and little protection at the back. And hit, you know, the sun hits up here, you know, the headache rack will take part of that. The top part will be silver up there, and we'll be painting this whole top part silver anyway. It'll look like she got a silver hat on. And like I said, 22/5 Super Singles. I replaced that one, and it was a bitch. And I got its twin in that box. In the box. It's in the box. And getting these mud flaps off was a bitch. Now, at the bottom of the mud flaps, you can see that they've been ripped off both sides, and then they flipped them, and that's fine, because that shit is tough as nails. I couldn't cut through it with my damn, I started sawing off the edge right there, because I was going to, you know, even it out. I'm like, fuck it. I'm just going to put the chrome tips on and call it a day. So, yes, now you've seen Black Betty. Now you know. No matter where you go, there you are. Oh yeah, it's, there's a kitty cat in there. Wow. And she purrs. She be purring. You ever heard her start up out here? It's worse out here. And then, there's the sun. he's just a 26-year-old, 27-year-old, rode hard, put away wet, but still in her prime, kind of cash truck. And she needs no introduction. She'd be world famous now, man. Get this up a little bit. We got things to do. We got things to do. All right. All right. All right, Sydney. Where's the def tank? Take this hand. Slide it into your pocket, Sydney. That's where my def tank is hiding, over in your front pocket. Doesn't exist, because we don't do def. We don't do def. We don't do DPF. We don't even do electronic logging. There's my electronic log. Doggies. That's right. Damn, 5 o'clock, rainy fucking day. I'm already tired. We're probably gonna call it a day. We're gonna call it a day. Yeah, but I hate to miss out on a damn good paying load that picks up later just because I'm being lazy. Really ought not be lazy. Shouldn't be lazy. That's what I feel like I'm being. So we got 800 for this load, and we will have some wait time at the pick. 2 hours for free. I was there for 6 hours. I was there over 6 hours. I think I got 6 hours of wait time alone, because I got there at 4-ish, and I got out right after midnight-ish. That's 8 hours. They get 2, so I get 6 hours of wait time on that, probably about $25 to $30 hour. So $160, $180 bucks extra on the 1800. This will be close to a $2,000 load, super light. In a minute, I'm gonna blow all that shit right on out. It's going in the dumper over there, and then I'm gonna leave. So yeah, I still got work to do. I don't know where else to put that shit. Started to blow it out on their fucking parking lot. It's just too immaculate. They wouldn't know it's me. Of course, they already had a bunch of shit there. Somebody else already blew out some shit over there, so I just don't want to be blamed for all of it, just the little bit that I got in the truck, the mountain that's back there, and it stinks so bad. I gotta put a fucking mask on and shit. I'm not even sure the fucking mask will help me. It's that shit's made with chemicals or something. It's got a chemical smell back there. I just, oh my god, man, I'm not even sure what I'm gonna do about all that business. But I'm gonna go and I'm going to do that business right now. And I'm going to let y'all go. I don't know. All right, Jason. All right. I'm going to be back in the back blowing it out for a little while. You have some load options. Oh, you're looking over there, Ryanator, the navigator. I got you. Heh. Yeah, I got to crawl in the back and blow out all that shit. I got a lot of shit in the back. I think I just made a mistake. I'm pretty sure I just made a mistake and I locked the fucking back door. I'm sure. Yeah. Okay. I gotta go. I gotta go blow it out. We'll holler at y'all. See you down the road.